thank you so much for coming out. We're going to have a brief program. We're going to beat the rain. The rain's going to hold out for us. You know, we're 75% to a goal that was set about 2 years ago. And it's amazing how far the city of Rochester has come in its parking strategy over the last 24 months. Today, June 25th, is an incredibly important day for our community. It's the first parking platform, parking structure, parking area that is raised in the city's history. At the time when we open the deck today, we will have more parking available in our city than any time in its history. And come November, we get to add another 300 to our parking system. So it's my pleasure, my honor to introduce to you this afternoon Mayor Jeffrey Cuthbertson. Mayor Cuthbertson has been a leader and a pusher on this project and many other, but the speed at which we were able to accomplish this was only with the cooperation of the entire city council, incredible group of professionals, the architects and the builders and staff all coming together with singular drive and focus. And I appreciate the cooperation from all of those folks. So without further ado, Mayor Cuthbertson.
Thank you very much, James. Welcome, everyone. As James indicated, we're joined here with the City Council and many other members of the public. I'd like to also recognize some other officials. Oakland County Commissioner Vice Chair Jeff Mattis, one of our former colleagues, and also members of the Chamber of Commerce, in particular Dave Walker, and who serves this year as chair, and many of the ambassadors who are here with us, members of the DDA, public business community, and law enforcement. So many wonderful faces that have been a part of this. As I think you can all agree, this is a great day for Rochester, its residents, businesses, and our greater community customers. However, it is a day, as James indicated, that has been a long time in the making. It has come through careful study and planning over the last 3 years, in fact, and a process that's involved many voices and experts, which City Council and the DDA have fostered and supported at every turn. I'm very proud to be here with you today and among those at the front in leading this charge. As we gather to cut a ribbon and look to the future of a stronger and more dynamic city of Rochester, I think it's important to take a few minutes and look back at how we got here. And it really starts in 2012, when the economy really began to improve and rebound, and particularly so here in Rochester. Our Planning Commission was confronted with several projects where parking really was a gating factor to development in our community. Similarly, the Planning Commission and the City Council have both long recognized that the previous parking exempt district boundaries, roughly on either side of Main Street, had the effect of picking land use winners and losers in terms of a very few not having to pay for parking on their property versus most who did. So, timeline since then. In December of 2012, Council approved an agreement with McKenna and Associates for a parking strategy as a supplement to our master plan project, which we actually received in April of 2013, and had a joint meeting of the Council, Planning Commission, and DDA to review the findings of the draft, which obviously involved general public input, merchants, landowner attendees, and other stakeholders. Ultimately, most of the recommendations in that study were adopted, and implementation work was commenced, and it really took root on March 14th, of 2014, when we installed and activated the on-street parking meters. Shortly thereafter, the city issued a request for proposals for design services for the parking platforms. And we added Rich and Associates to our team, who have been an inestimable asset to the city and this project. Similarly, on May 29th, 2014, we issued a request for proposals for construction of the parking platforms and ultimately retained Frank Rewald and Son to serve as our construction manager. And I'd like to note their estimates and bid packages working with Rich were absolutely outstanding and had a great deal to do with the financial success of this project, which I'll talk more about in a bit. From June 2014 on, design and site plans were developed for both this platform as well as the one on the west side, also under construction, and those were presented to the City Council and Planning Commission for approval. In December of 14, Council adopted a resolution authorizing the sale of general obligation bonds in the amount of $12 million. For the construction of this platform and the one on the west side, along with associated parking system improvements. For a city with virtually no debt, this was a major commitment. And then, on a very cold January 5th, 2015, right here, brutally cold in fact, we had a groundbreaking event and construction on the east parking platform began. More importantly, and I think one of the real silver linings of this project, on January 9th, Standard & Poor's rating service issued a AAA bond rating for our city's general obligation bonds, which I know you may or may not have heard me mention a couple of times this year. But those bonds were sold at auction at 2.73%, which is absolutely outstanding. And saved over $1.7 million in the construction costs and interest costs of these projects over the life of those bonds. And then finally, on February 9th of this year, the west parking platform construction also began. So here we are on June 25th, 2015, at the ribbon cutting for the east parking platform project. Folks, this is just 24 weeks and 3 days since a shovel went in the ground from groundbreaking. Yes. For those of you counting, that is 171 days and a truly amazing accomplishment. And just a few statistics about this platform. There are 260 spaces in the platform and the alley adjacent. And the projected final cost will be about $4.34 million, which, for those of you who are counting, and I know me and my colleagues are, that will be under the guaranteed maximum price budget by about 15%. So, tremendous. And that yields a cost of roughly $16,700 per space. Indeed, there are a lot of people here to thank today, including the City Council, the Planning Commission, and the Downtown Development Authority. I would also like to recognize the members of the Parking Advisory Committee, which include myself and the Mayor Pro Tem, but moreover, Vito Pampelona, Eldon Thompson, and Missy Markovics. Their service has truly been invaluable. Similarly, I'd like to thank the adjacent businesses, their customers, and neighbors for patience and support in delivering this landmark project on time and under budget. Specifically, on the project team, we need to recognize a lot of hard work, which has yielded today, in fact, and expertise that brought it here on schedule. In particular, I'd like to recognize and thank Matt Jobin, who is an architect from Rich & Associates. Matt? His colleague, Rick Cannell, also of Rich & Associates. Rick? Thank you. From Frank Rewald & Sons, Mike Gagnon, who is the project manager. Mike? And Jerry Seelbach, who is still working. All four of these gentlemen worked exceptionally well together and have been an outstanding project team that I think everyone here can be very proud of. In addition, IPS is the precast panel company that, and the main contractor, in fact, on this project. They've done a great job both with production quality and panel installation. Let's give them a round of applause too, please. Quick aside, informed sources tell me that the Big Red Crane will be done sometime before the 4th of July holiday, with the final panels being put in place on the west side. So truly amazing progress underway. Last but not least, I'd like to thank the city administration team who have pushed this every day for the last 171 days and the 2.5 years that preceded. In particular, the city manager, James Vetrano, deputy manager Nick Banda, executive director of the DDA, Christy Trevero, who, by the way, helped organize today's event with a little help from Fox Automotive, who were the sponsors of our self-driven limousines today. So thank you for that. Most of all, I'd like to thank Police Chief Steve Schettenhelm, whose determination and subject matter knowledge, both on parking and security, has been critical. Thank you, Chief. So in closing, I would like to thank all of you and each of you for your contribution to this tremendous success for Rochester. It is a truly landmark project for the development of our downtown and our business community. And let's take a little more time to briefly celebrate this accomplishment and go cut a ribbon. Thank you. Very briefly, I'd like to welcome a representative from Brooks Patterson's office today to present a plaque to the city.
We'd like to recognize Rochester, its partners, the downtown, the chamber, the planning commission, to the mayor, a proclamation from L. Brooks Patterson recognizing Rochester on this day, and congratulations on your parking structure.
Thank you very much.
All right, one, two, three. This is another great day for Rochester, its residents, its businesses, and our greater community customers. I'd like to first introduce my colleagues on the City Council, Mayor Pro Tem Ben Giovanelli, Councilmember Kathy Dalton, Councilmember Kim Russell, Councilmember Stuart Bixon, and Councilmember Rob Ray. These are the people that, working with the community, with administration, with the merchants, with the DDA, with the Planning Commission, that brought this to fruition. And I believe that the community looking forward will think very highly of the decisions that have been made. I'm very proud today to be here at the front of those leading this charge. Obviously, it's been a day long in the making. We're gathered here today to cut a ribbon that really is a look to a future of a stronger and more dynamic Rochester. We had a former parking exempt district that magically made parking requirements not apply on either side of Main Street, but somehow they applied everywhere else, and that created market imbalances as well. We didn't think that picking winners or losers in the parking system was an appropriate way to govern, so we've done our best to make everyone a winner. Including the taxpayer who used to have to pay about $250,000 to $300,000 a year to subsidize a parking system that lost money and, frankly, didn't have the capacity that we needed. So the council and the DDA commissioned a study, a parking study, to look at this from a scientific, fact-based
standpoint. And what we learned is that, gee whiz, we need most parking, new parking, where we're standing and where we stood on the other side of the street on June and cut a ribbon earlier this year. We started this project that kicked off at the beginning of January, and here we are just 10 months later with 550 parking spaces and structured platforms in this community. It's an absolutely amazing achievement, and I think that the project team really, really deserves a round of applause for that. And this parking deck with an additional level has 297 spaces, and I'm told that over 20,000 man hours of labor went into the construction of this structure, and it involved over 7,000 cubic yards of cement. And in all, we have 532 decked spaces in Rochester now. The structures themselves came in at $1.25 million under budget, and we came... Yes. And we came in 24 days ahead of schedule. Obviously, there have been a lot of affected businesses, particularly those in the 400 block of Main Street. It's been a long time coming. It also involved the alley being closed. The alley was actually rebuilt, and if you walk through it, I think you'll see the foreshadow of what alleys in this community can look like in the future. They're not just going to be delivery doors and fire egress, but a part of the pedestrian traffic for our community going forward. This obviously required a lot of sacrifice on their part, and I do want to sincerely thank them for their engagement and patience and understanding that this is a part of Rochester's infrastructure moving forward. So thank you. I see many faces here, but thank all of you very much for your help. If there's somebody to thank for the architecture, the really clean look of this structure, Rich and Associates, I think, really fitted this building in to the community in a way that as large as it is, really complements our downtown. So thank you, Matt. We were very proud to have a Rochester business who was very, very close, I think within maybe $20,000 of being the low bidder, but with the addition of the parking spaces next to the Rochester Mills, Frank Rewald and Son did a fantastic job here with these platforms. And I'd like to thank Frank Rewald, who's here. Your team really should be commended, and we hope that we hope your work here is the beginning of many construction parking platform construction projects throughout Metro Detroit. I'll be happy to be a reference, Frank. Final group is IPS, who are the precast panel company. They did a fantastic job with production quality and the installation, so many thanks to them. And certainly, Deputy and Interim Manager Nick Banda, DDA Executive Director Christy Trevorrow, Chief Schettenhelm, all played instrumental roles in this. Your subject matter and day-to-day work on this project were absolutely critical. Special thanks to Christy for helping to organize this, as well as to gathering the transportation today for council and members of the committee. We had help from Bill Fox Chevrolet, Shelton Pontiac Buick, Mercedes-Benz of Rochester, and Rochester Hills Chrysler Jeep. Before we go downstairs and cut a ribbon, we have a little special ceremony today. There's one person who is in the audience with his family who helped this project from beginning to end with great discipline and acumen, not only on the construction side, the bidding side, but really in helping the committee build the pro forma for the parking system. And that's our former city manager, James Vetrano. I'd like if James could come up here, please. James, this is your second to last day as a consultant with the city of Rochester, I understand. But we have a special gift for you today, James, in appreciation for your work with this project and for the city. The council and I, we have, we'll actually do the resolution at the next meeting, but we have a very special gift that Councilmember Rob Ray is going to present to you. This is a key to the city. It's a bit of a new tradition here in Rochester. But if I could read it. It's presented to James Vetrano for his exemplary service and tireless dedication to the citizens and city of Rochester. And it's just one sentence, but it speaks truth in great volume, James. So thank you.
Thank you.
So with that, I want to thank you all, each of you and all of you, for your contribution. We're going to go downstairs. Let's cut a ribbon.
What? You here. Oh, I'm taking pictures.
All right. Has everybody had a chance for pictures? All right. Here we go. One, two, three, go.